on the rope.
Yep.
Okay. All right. When you shift, though, get you a little bit.
I know what you're saying.
I know what your strategy is. Don't shift too much without dropping something off on it. Okay?
Yep.
All right, then.
Right. Boy, I know you didn't hear, but I'm bad. Okay. Protect yourself at all times.
Punch is feeling any different. You ain't feeling any different.
See, it's
ain't lighting up yet, huh?
I'm up with stone.
I got you.
Uh-huh. It's okay.
Just keep doing what you're doing.
This is what it's like, folks. You're in the corner, and there it comes. George, watching what Roy Jones is doing to a big guy like Gonzalez, can you project him against some smaller guys like Hopkins and Trinidad?
Now, this guy's foxy enough to fight in any weight division he wants. They will not be able to hit him with any sharp punches. He's able to get out of the way too quick. And he thinks constantly.
A very rare combination there, a right hand followed by a right uppercut.
He dictates the fight, pace, and he throws shots when he wants. And he makes you afraid when he doesn't want to throw shots.
Gonzalez definitely now rode up. Now he's anxious to leave himself open for those quick punches. So the question may be, is Roy Jones willing to go at him to try to finish him?
He's able to land three rights to the body, Roy Jones did. Just when the guy's expecting to protect his body, he goes up on top of the right hand.
Jones lunging through with a left hook upstairs.
Jones is directing his strategy to the body now for some reason. Just when this guy starts to protect himself a little bit, he's going to open up back on top. That's what he's hoping. Overhand right by Roy Jones Jr. The crowd voicing their opinion. I think they want to see a little bit more action.
Has Jones slowed down a little bit?
You know, his best shot was that earlier punch in the beginning of the fight, and I don't think he's going to get any more powerful as the fight goes on. He is not the biggest guy for the light heavyweight division, so you don't expect that knockout power in the latter round. That body whipping he's giving Gonzalez will make you sit on the stool and not get up.
Gonzalez told us he won't be going anywhere, and he isn't. Still alive here in the eighth round.
He's not too many. He's not throwing that many punches anymore. All right?
Yeah.
All right. Now you can get to him if you wanted to. It's all up to you now. Come on. Okay?
Yeah.
You can get to him. You can get to him. Think positive.
Come on, Talawa. Come on, Talawa.
Hit the sun. You close enough to throw the right hand. Throw it. And get down. Number three. Okay?
Yeah.
You delaying 1 second. Don't delay any punches.
Okay, Tama.
Let it go.
Let it go. You know what? Gentlemen, you gotta clean this up. You're making too much of a... Follow it.
The question that his trainer really is asking Gonzalez is, have you decided to merely survive? Is this fight over? Or you still have it in you to go for a win?
Yeah,
This is not unlike many fights we've seen Roy Jones in early in the fight. An opponent is fresh, perhaps a little hopeful. He comes to Jones. Jones begins to pepper him. The opponent backs off. Jones takes his time to break him down, and we get rounds like we just did.
Larry, is this the kind of fight that is going to endear Jones' critics?
Come on, let's punch!
In terms of Roy believing he should be pound for pound the best fighter in the world.
Well, first half of the fight, he may have given his critics something to think about. Not that they wanted to put him above Trinidad and Mosley, but that at 32 years of age, he still brings something to the party that's very special. We'll see how the last six rounds go.
Two uppercuts from Roy Jones. Sneaks in another quick one there with the left hand, and then goes to work with the right hand.
The fighter like Gonzalez just stays in the fight. There's always something that can happen if you just keep throwing punches. Corner told him not to wait. Just do what you're going to do. Don't faint it. No punches.
George, you're speaking from first-hand expertise in the Michael Moore fight.
You just got to throw punches. Can't wait for a quick fighter to get in the position.
Gonzalez looks a little dazed.
Jones down. Starting to heat up as the ninth round comes to a close.
And he ran into a right hand himself.
Winds up with two left hooks. Gonzalez comes right back and shows. And Gonzalez exchanging power to end the ninth round.
There you go. That's what I'm talking about.
Way to give me them angles on the punch. Way to keep them turning. Okay, we go out in the 10. That's what I'm talking about. Let's get a little bit of that in every once in a while. Give me some deep breath. Don't chop.
All right.
Flick at him. Try to throw him off now. Give me a little of that stuff you use, okay?
Make it away. Take that point. Now give him the point.
Come on, Talawa. Come on.
Whack him good in the way. Drop that son of a bitch. Double jab, right in, hit him in the body, take him down. Take him down. All right, let's go.
There you see he threatens a bolo punch and comes across with a right hand. Not like too many other punches you've seen thrown lifetime.
Roy Jones is so talented, has so much skill, but it just depends on how much he wants to put on display. Let's bring in Harold to see how he has it through nine.
Okay, Fred. Eight rounds to one, 89-80 Roy Jones Jr. Give him an extra point. The rounds 1 and 5 for the knockdowns. And I tell you, the rest of the rounds, he's just pulling out all the tricks. Do you notice where he went southpaw in the last round?
Jones tried to pick up the pace in the last round as well, Harold, landing 21 of 36 power shots at a 58% clip. Incidentally, Julio Gonzalez has never scored a knockdown past the ninth round. it would appear he needs a knockout to win the fight.
Roy Jones has been able to land good body shots throughout this fight, which doesn't leave Gonzalez with a lot of power for the latter round. Those body shots take all of your energy as far as knockout power away.
And that is the Jones staple. Wear you down, wear you down. Work the body, break you down. And as he says, he likes to get his fighters to quit.
Gonzalez looking for one good shot. You're not going to get it. You must throw your hands. Let your hands go.
Roy Jones revealed in the build-up for this fight that he has suffered from this big right hand from Jones, and he comes back with a left hook.
Gonzalez should just say, look, this guy's hit me with his best shot. I'm just going to mix it up with him and throw something with him. If you're going to get hit anyway, you may as well be throwing shots.
Larry Jones has only been down once in his career. Flash knockdown by Lee Del Val. In the fight he won going away. It's hard to imagine that he can be knocked out to lose this fight.
We talked about Roy Jones' status on the pound-for-pound list, Larry. Tell me yours.
Well, here's a personal look at the pound for pound. I've jumped Felix Trinidad ahead of Shane Mosley because Trinidad is fighting the best fighters out there one after another. Roy Jones believes that he should be number one forever because he once was and he hasn't lost. But this is a what have you done for us lately kind of a show. Bernard Hopkins has defended his middleweight title 13 times. Oscar De La Hoya. Mayweather, Barrera, Morales, Park Wai, and Vargas finish my top 10.